In the last video, we learned the simplest method for integrating a differential equation, the Euler method. In this video, I want to show you a simple modification to the Euler method called the modified Euler method that will increase the accuracy of the integration. And it will also give us a hint on how we can then construct a family of integration methods, which is called the Runge-Kutta family. Okay, so we're solving x dot equals f of tx. Let me draw the graph again. So we have t and x. And let's say that we already made it to the nth step. So we have t sub n here. And then we have the value of the function here is x sub n. So we know this point here on the graph. Then we use the differential equation to integrate forward. So let's say x dot gives us a slope. So let's say it looks something like this. And then we integrate forward then along the tangent line. So we have tn plus delta t, and that gets us to this point here, which then is xn plus 1. Okay? Now, Euler method just uses the slope at tn, but if we look at the slope of this function at tn plus delta t, the slope would have changed, so we can draw something like this as a slope. So you see that the accuracy of the Euler method is hindered because we only use the slope at t equals tn. But the slope is changing everywhere along this line, in particular at tn plus delta t. In the next time step, we have a different slope. So the modified Euler method says, okay, we have these two slopes. Why don't we take the average of those two slopes? So naively, you can write down a formula then for the average. We would have something like xn plus 1 equals xn plus delta t. And then I can divide by 2 because I'm taking the average of two slopes. So we would have the slope down at the first point, so that would be f of tn xn. And then we would have the slope at the second point, so that would be f of tn plus delta t xn plus 1. Okay? So that would be the naive way of averaging these two slopes, right? This slope here is this slope is f of tn xn, and then this slope is f of tn plus delta t xn plus 1, right? The problem, though, is that this is what we're trying to solve, so we don't know this, right? So it's not a useful formula in the way that it stands. That's what we're trying to solve. So instead of this formula, we can use what's called a predictor-corrector type of method, predictor-corrector method, which says that first we predict the value of xn plus 1 using Euler's method. So xn plus 1 predicted, so I'll put a p here, is equal to xn plus delta t f of tn xn. And then our corrector then takes the predicted value and then uses it as in this average formula. So the corrector part of the method would be xn plus 1 equals xn plus then the average here, delta t over 2, of f of tn xn plus f of tn plus delta t xn plus 1. But here we're using the predicted value using Euler's method of xn plus 1. Okay? This turns out to be a more accurate method than just the Euler method. So this is called the modified Euler method. Okay? So instead of using the value of the slope just at tn, we're averaging the value at tn and tn plus delta t. But to get the slope at tn plus delta t, we're essentially using Euler's method. Okay. The reason I want to talk about this method is because this is actually an instance of a second-order Runge-Kutta method. Okay? So I should write that down, Runge-Kutta method. Okay? And it's a second order, so we write that as RK2. Okay? Second order Runge-Kutta method. The way that one writes a Runge-Kutta method is to write stages on the method. We call them stage one, stage two. A second order method has two stages. A third order method has three stages. A fourth order method has four stages. It doesn't quite continue that sequence, but higher order methods have more stages. So how do we write this in terms of stages? Traditionally, you use the symbol k1 and k2. Here, we can define k1 in the first stage will be this delta t times f of tn xn. Okay, so this k1 will show up in our final solution. Delta t times f of tn xn will be our k1, okay? In the second stage, k2, we would have delta t. And then instead of that tn, we are looking at tn plus delta t, so tn plus delta t. And then the value of x that we're going to use, so this is going to be our k2 piece here. So this will be our k1 piece. This delta t times this will be our k1 piece. Delta t times this second term will be our k2 piece. So xn plus 1 predicted is xn plus delta t f of tn xn. So this is xn plus delta t f of tn xn is actually k1. So we write this as xn plus k1. Okay, so that's the notation we use for Runge-Kutta. So we have our k1, and then our k2 is going to be this piece. So that xn plus 1 then will work out to be xn then plus the average, 1/2, of k1 plus k2. Okay, so k1 is our delta t f of tn xn. K2 is our delta t f of tn plus delta t xn plus 1 predicted. Xn 1 plus 1 predicted is xn plus kn. Okay, this is kind of the standard form for writing a second order Runge-Kutta method. The idea in the next video then would be to generalize this. In fact, you don't have to consider the slope at the beginning and the end of the interval. You can consider the slope anywhere within this interval. But then we have some constraints that we have to satisfy. And the constraint is that it's supposed to become a second order method. We'll see how that works in the next video. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.